Namaskar. Welcome to our channel Narasegal. In this video, that is part 7 of Class 1 Mathematics first chapter Real Numbers, we are going to learn how to find HCF of two numbers and solve third and fourth problems into this Class 1 Mathematics textbook page number 4. And we have already solved the first and second problems in our previous video, that is part 6. And please also check out all the videos, that is part 1, part 2, part 3 of our channel Class 1 Mathematics to understand this chapter and in this video very clearly. And all contact information and all links are available in the description. And I have already created a channel, Nori Teacher, which uploads videos about math, science, general knowledge, etc. So please also check out my channel, and all contact information is available in the description. And now, to buy things online or to do online shopping, you can check out my friend's channel, that is Online Shopping Review, which uploads a new video every day. That may be jewelry, saris, dresses and kurtis. They review each and every item they sell. So please subscribe, share and like their channel, and all contact information for their channel is available in the description. Now, before going to solve the problems in Do This textbook page number 4, Class 1 Mathematics, first we need to revise the conditions and equation we learned from Euclid's division lemma in the previous videos. And the first is the Euclid's division lemma equation, that is A is equal to B into Q plus R. And the remainder condition, that is 0 is less than or equal to or less than b. And the divisional form, that is a is always divided by b. And to find which is what is the value of a and what is the value of b, we have a condition, that is a is always greater than b. So the greater number becomes a and the smaller number becomes b. And all these conditions are listed in the right side of the all the four conditions. And now first we read the question. Do this. Now the question is, find the HCF of the following using Euclid's division lemma. We need to find the HCF of these numbers using Euclid's division lemma. The third and fourth questions. And the question is 300 and 550. We need to find the HCF of the two numbers 300 and 550. First we need to know what is A and what is B. We know that A is always greater than B. So the greater number becomes A, the smaller number becomes B. Greater number here is 550. So A is equal to 550. We write A is equal to 550 and automatically B is equal to 300. And we write the Euclid's division lemma equation according to Euclid's division lemma. We write that equation A is equal to B into Q plus R, and we highlight the equation. And now we substitute these values, that is A and B, in this equation. So we write in the place of A, here we write 550 is equal to 300 into 300 ones are 300. 300 twos are 600. 600 becomes greater than 550. So we write 300 into 1. 300 into 1 plus, and what's the value of 550 minus 300? 550 minus 300 is 250. So the remainder here is 250. 250. And now, here the remainder didn't become equal to 0. The remainder here is 250. So we continue the process until the remainder becomes 0. And here we have already divided 550 with 300. So we avoid this number. We kept this number aside and in these two numbers, that is B and R. In B and R, the greater number again becomes A and the smaller number becomes B, and we continue the process. And here the greater number is 300. So we write here A is equal to 300, B is equal to 250. And we again substitute these values in the equation. So we write 300 is equal to 250 into. We know that 250 into 1s are 250. 250 into 2s are 500. It becomes greater than 300. So we write here 1. 250 into 1 plus. And what's the value of 300 minus 250? 300 minus 250 is 50. So here the remainder becomes 50. And here also the remainder didn't become equal to 0. The remainder here is 50. So again we kept this number aside. We avoid this number, and in these two numbers the greater number becomes A and the smaller number becomes B. So we write the same here. A is equal to 250 and B is equal to 50. We again continue the process until the remainder becomes 0. So we write here 250 is equal to 50 into, we know that 55 are 250 directly. So we write here 50 into 5. And 250 minus 250 is 0. So the remainder here became 0. As 250 minus 250 is 0, the remainder became equal to 0. And in this equation, where the remainder became equal to 0, here the remainder became equal to 0. And here, the value of B. In this equation, the value of B. We know that it's A. It is B. It is Q. And it is O. And here, the remainder became equal to 0. And here, in this equation, the value of B becomes the HCF of two numbers. Here, HCF. So, we write HCF of 300 and 550 is 50. So, this is the way to find the HCF of two numbers using Euclid's division lemma. We divide these numbers and we continue the process until the remainder becomes 0. And in that equation, particularly where the remainder becomes 0, we write all is A, B, Q and all, and the value of B becomes the HCF. So we write HCF of 350 is 50. And we solve the fourth problem now. Now we are going to solve the fourth problem in do this, the last problem. And the question is 1860, 1860 and 2050. We need to find the HCF between these two numbers. And we know that A is always greater than B. So here the greater number becomes A, smaller number becomes B. Here the greater number is 2015. So we write A is equal to 2015 and B is equal to 1860. And we write the Euclid's division lemma equation A is equal to B into Q plus R. We need to write this in every problem according to Euclid's division lemma. We write the equation A is equal to B into Q plus R. And we need to highlight this equation. Now, we substitute these A and B values in this equation. Similarly, how we did in the last question, and the same process, we apply the same process, we substitute these values. 2015 is equal to 1860 into 1860 into 1 is 1860. 1860 into 2 will be greater than 2015. So we put here, so we write here 1. So 1860 into 1 plus, and what's the value of 2015 minus 1860? That is 155. So the remainder here is 155. As the remainder in this equation is 155, we need to continue the process until in the equation where the remainder becomes equal to 0. And now this number is already divided. So we get this number as A, and in these two numbers B and R, B and R, the greater number again becomes A and the smaller number becomes B. So we write A is equal to 1860. We know that it is a bigger number. And B is equal to 155. And we substitute these values in the same manner. So we write here, 1860. So we write here 1860 is equal to 155 into. We know that 155 tens are 1550. And 155 twelves are directly 1860. So we directly write here 12. And plus 1860 minus 1860 is equal to 0. So here in this equation, the remainder became equal to 0. So we denote this. It's A, it's B, it's Q, it's O. And here in this equation, the remainder became equal to 0. In that equation, the value of B becomes the HCF of two numbers. Here the value of B is 155. So 155 becomes HCF of 1860 and 2015. So we write here in conclusion, HCF of 1860 and 2015 is 150. And in the next video, we will solve the think and discuss in page number 4, Class in Mathematics textbook. The question is, can you find a HCF of 0.12 and 1.2? Finding HCF of the decimal numbers. And thanks for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe, share, like, comment for more videos. Thank you.